Greetings dear aspirants. In this session, we'll be seeing some practice questions which will be helpful for your UPSC Prelims Examination 2020. Let us now move on to the discussion. Which one of the following is not a domain of the Niti Aayog's health index? And they have given four options: health outcomes, governance and information, key inputs and processes, and conservation. If you take this year's prelims question paper, you can find a question like, which one of the following is not a sub-index of the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business Index? So such questions may come at the examination. There are only three domains with a total of 23 indicators for the health index, which has been developed by Niti Aayog. It has been the practice of Niti Aayog because in both the editions of the index, the domains were same. The domains of health index are health outcomes, governance and information, and key inputs and processes. So conservation is no way related with health. So you can easily eliminate this conservation statement as well. In prelims question this year, they gave maintenance of law and order as one of the option for the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business Index, and that was the correct answer for that particular question. For this question, the correct answer is option D, conservation. Moving on to the second question. Consider the following statements about prison statistics and prisons act. They have given two statements and I have asked you to choose the correct answer. Here the first statement is incorrect. The prison statistics, the crime in India statistics and the statistics with respect to the accident and suicide deaths are released by National Crime Records Bureau. If you see, this National Crime Records Bureau comes under the Ministry of Home Affairs. The National Institute of Social Defense is a central advisory body for the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment of the Government of India. Though it develops tools, programs for correctional administration in prisons, it is not releasing the official prison statistics of the country. If you see, this institute also involves in training the authorities in prison and correctional administration. Now, the second statement, it is correct as the section 59, subsection 25 of the Prisons Act of 1894 makes way for the state government to provide rules for the appointment and guidance of visitors of prisons. These visitors are not the visitors of prisoners. They are a board of official and non-official visitors who make observations about the living conditions and care and welfare of prisoners by having frequent visits. So for this question, only statement 2 is correct. The correct answer is option B. Moving on to the third question, which of the following refers to children under the age of 5 having low weight to their height? And four options are child stunting, chronic undernutrition, child wasting and undernourishment. If you see, this given statement is the definition of child wasting. When we say child stunting, it means children having low height to their corresponding age. It reflects chronic malnutrition or chronic undernutrition, and acute malnutrition is reflected by child wasting. And undernourishment refers to having less calorie intake. The average per capita consumption of poorest 30% population of India is much lower than the required number of calories. So here the correct answer is option C, child wasting, which means the children under the age of 5 having low weight to their height. The question is, a regional comprehensive economic partnership agreement has been proposed between a set of countries and an organization in the Asia Pacific region in 2012. The agreement is proposed between. Now, whenever you are knowing or studying about Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership or RCEP, remember ASEAN. If you see, this RCEP has been proposed among 10 ASEAN members and 6 free trade partners of ASEAN, which also includes the countries of India, Australia, China, South Korea, Japan and New Zealand. So here the correct answer is option C, ASEAN and India, Australia, China, South Korea, Japan and New Zealand. Consider the following statements with respect to United Nations Security Council. The first statement is it consists of 5 permanent members and 10 non-permanent members. And the second statement is that the non-permanent members are elected for the period of 2 years on the recommendations of one of the permanent members of the council. And statement 3 is, historically, India is neither permanent nor a non-permanent member of the council. They have asked you to choose the correct statement. Now, read the statements once again. We saw that United Nations Security Council consists of 5 permanent members and 10 non-permanent members. And these 10 non-permanent members are elected by the United Nations General Assembly based on the respective regions. So there were 5 different regions which we saw, but not on the recommendations of permanent member. So here the statement 1 is correct and the second statement is not correct. Then moving on to the third statement, though India is not a permanent member, it has served as a non-permanent member in the past. So the third statement is also incorrect here because it is given that it was neither a permanent nor a non-permanent member of the United Nations Security Council. The question is asked for the correct statements. The correct statement is only the first statement. So the answer is option A, 1 only. Question is, which of the following is part of the representative list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity from India that is maintained by UNESCO? And they have given 4 items. First one is the Kalbelia, second one Raman, third Yoga, and 4 Vashi. And they have asked to choose the correct answer from the options. Here the question is asked, which of the following is part of this representative list, and especially from India? Kalbelia, Raman, and Yoga are a part of this list that is corresponding or belonging to India. Vashi is also on this list, but it corresponds to Japan. The question is asked to choose the correct items. The correct answer is option B, 1, 2, and 3 only, since Vashi will not come under this list. Moving on to the next question, consider the following statements with reference to National Human Rights Commission. And the question has given some 3 statements and it has asked to choose the correct statements. Now, if you look at the first statement, it states that NHRC is a constitutional body. But if you look at statement 3, it states that it was established by the Protection of Human Rights Act of 1993. If it was established by an act, then it becomes a statutory body because an act is a statute. This means if statement 1 is correct, statement 3 is wrong, or vice versa. So they both cannot be correct together. This means we can eliminate options which has both 1 and 3. The commission was established by the Protection of Human Rights Act of 1993. This makes statement 3 as the correct statement and statement 1 as incorrect, like we just discussed. So we can eliminate option A as well. Here the second statement states that the Chief Justice of India is the chairperson of the commission. Now, in this statement, you may make a mistake because the former Chief Justice of India is the chairperson of the commission. Here, the statement just mentions Chief Justice of India, which indicates to the present Chief Justice of India. So, in a hurry, just by seeing Chief Justice of India, don't mark statement 2 as correct. Here, statement 2 is incorrect. So, the correct answer to this question is option C, 3-1B. Moving on to the next question. The next question is about GST. It has given 2 statements and has asked you to choose the correct statement. Here, the first statement may confuse you because you may know that GST was introduced by an amendment to the Constitution, but you may not be sure by which amendment. It is the 101st Amendment to the Constitution of India in the year 2016. So, the statement 1 here is correct. The second statement is also confusing because you may think that GST is a tax which is related to the commerce of the country. You can remember this by just a small trick. Remember that GST is a tax and it is a revenue to the government, which means it is a finance to the government. So the actual ministry is the Ministry of Finance, not the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So the correct answer to this question is option A, 1 only, since the question is asked to choose the correct statements. Consider the following statements about malaria, and they have given 2 statements and have asked for the correct answer. Here, the first statement is correct. Malaria is a vector-borne disease caused by Plasmodium parasites, especially by Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium falciparum. The parasites are spread to people through the bites of infected female Anopheles mosquitoes. Here, the second statement is wrong. Sexual transmission of malaria is not possible. In rare cases, malaria can also be transmitted through blood transfusion, organ transplant, or the shared use of needles or syringes contaminated with blood. Here, the question is asked for the correct statements. The correct answer is option A, 1-1B. Next question, which among the following describes superconductivity, which is often seen in the news? The question is asked for the description of superconductivity. Superconductivity has 2 main characteristics. First is zero resistance, and then is the diamagnetism. From this, we know that the answer should contain zero resistance, which is available in option C and D, so we can directly eliminate other two options. In these two options C and D, one says it conducts electricity and another says it stops the conducting of electricity. Look, it is very obvious that superconductivity should mean conducting electricity, because we know conductor is a material in which electricity easily travels, so we can eliminate the option which says does not or stop the conduct of electricity. Hence, correct answer is option D. It is the ability of certain materials to conduct electric current with zero resistance. So, option D is the correct answer. Lower policy repo rate announcement by Reserve Bank of India denotes which of the following? When the policy repo rate or the repo rate is being reduced by the bank, it means that the bank rates will also become lower. And why it has gone for the reduction in policy repo rate is because the economy is growing at a very slower pace. And also the investments and the money supply are in the lower side. So here the correct answer is option B, the money supply in the economy needs to be boosted. So when the bank reduces the bank rates, the money supply in the economy can be boosted. Next question. The National Institute of Labor Economics Research and Development is an autonomous institute under which of the following? National Institute of Labor Economics Research and Development is an autonomous institute under Niti Aayog. So the correct answer is option C, Niti Aayog. Agenda 2063, recently seen in the news, is associated with which of the following? So they have given European Union, African Union, International Customs Union and South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. The Agenda 2063 is the master plan for the transforming Africa into global powerhouse for the future. They are determined to achieve this in a 50-year period from the year 2013 to 2063. In this question, if you look at the statements, you can tell that the statement 2 is correct, because it is known that Dr. Homi Jahangir Baba is known as the father of the Indian nuclear program. So this eliminates option C. Now, the first statement tells that BARC comes under the Department of Atomic Energy. It is correct. And please include this in your notes that BARC comes under the Department of Atomic Energy. So this makes statement 1 as correct. Now we have to see whether statement 3 is correct or not. The name is Baba Atomic Research Center. So we know that the center is involved in nuclear sciences as atomic energy is a discipline of nuclear science. But in the question, it states that BARC is involved only in the field of research in nuclear sciences. Now, you may easily get carried away by this logic and may consider statement 3 as correct, but it is actually wrong. So, it is where the newspaper reading and analysis is useful. Four startups have tied up with BARC to manufacture the unique membrane-based water purifiers. But water is not a discipline of nuclear science. So from this, we can tell that BARC is involved in multidisciplinary research as well. BARC or BARC does societal commitment domains of research and application as well. Now, these points make sure that the word only should not be there in the statement. So it makes this third statement wrong. So this question is asked for the correct statements. The correct answer is option B, 1 and 2 only. Next question, which among the following is are the member states of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation? And they have given some five nations, which includes Saudi Arabia, Iran, Bangladesh, India and Pakistan. Here all the countries are members except India. Please keep this in mind. So the question is asked for the correct answer. So the correct answer is option D, 1, 2, 3 and 5 only, because India is not a member of OIC. Next question, who among the following are the members of G20 grouping? They have given four countries, India, European Union, Japan and South Africa. The G20 summit for this year was held in Japan in the city of Osaka. India, European Union and the BRICS grouping along with the USA are part of this G20 grouping. If you see, the South Africa also comes under this BRICS grouping. The other members of BRICS grouping are Brazil, Russia, India and China. So all the countries given in this question are correct. The question is asked for the correct answer. The correct answer is option D, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The next question, Consider the following statements with respect to BS6 norms. Now, they've given two statements and I've asked you to choose the correct answer. The first statement is BS6 norms are meant for automobiles only, but not for the fuels of automobiles. These BS6 norms are not only for automobiles, but also for fuel. The first statement is incorrect. Moving on to the second statement, India is targeting to implement these norms with effect from 1st of April 2020. Therefore, this second statement is correct. So here, the question is asked for the correct statements. The correct answer is option B, 2 only, since only the second statement is correct. Question is about the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act of 1967. They have given two statements and have asked you to choose the correct statements. Here, the first statement which has been stated or given here is correct, and it is a part of statement of object and reasons of bringing this act based on the recommendations of Committee of National Integration and Regionalism. Therefore, the statement is correct. Now, come to the second statement. It actually tells that the act defines unlawful activity and unlawful association, but does not define terrorist act. The act also defines terrorist act in section 15 of the act. The term unlawful activity and unlawful association are explained in section 2O and 2P of the act. Therefore, though the statement is partly correct, it becomes an incorrect statement because the terrorist act is also defined under this act. So the question is asked for the correct statements. Here statement 2 is wrong, so the correct answer is option A, 1 only. Consider the following statements with reference to wholesale price index. They have given four statements and I have asked you to choose the correct statements. Consider the first statement, that is nothing but the definition of wholesale price index. This first statement is correct. Now, the second statement, it is wrong because WPI or the wholesale price index is compiled and released on monthly basis by the Office of Economic Advisor, not the Central Statistical Office. And this Office of Economic Advisor comes under the Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Now, the statement 3 is correct because the base year used for calculation is 2011-12 only. And the final statement here, the first part of the statement is right, that is wholesale price index is calculated under three major groups, namely primary, articles, manufactured products and fuel and power, but not services, because services are not included in wholesale price index. So here the question is asked for the correct statements. The correct answer is option 1 and 3, 1B. The Periodic Labor Force Survey 2017-18 was launched by which of the following ministry? And here this is a direct question. We know that it was launched by the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. We discussed this during our analysis. So the correct answer here is option C. Next question, which of the following nations as being part of a bilateral naval exercise with India and also a part of Quad dialogue but not a part of Malabar multilateral exercise, and they have given four countries: Japan, United States, United Kingdom and Australia. Quad consists of four nations, namely India, Japan, United States of America and Australia. So we can directly eliminate option C from this question, which is the United Kingdom. Now, know that India and USA started the Malabar exercise as a bilateral exercise in the year 1992 and Japan joined this exercise in the year 2007. So, it became a multilateral exercise, but know that Australia has not yet joined. So, Australia here is the correct answer because it is part of Quad dialogue but not a part of Malabar multilateral exercise, and also it has conducted some joint naval exercise with India. Moving on, they have given two statements and they are asking which of the statements are correct. Here, the first statement is wrong because the 86th Constitutional Amendment Act of 2002 deals with Article 21A of Indian Constitution. It is nothing but regarding a fundamental right to education. So, it has no connection with the Council of Ministers. And if you see the Article 75, 1A was inserted by the 91st Constitutional Amendment Act of 2003. And here the second statement is correct, as the total number of ministers including the Prime Minister in the Council of Ministers shall not exceed 15% of the total number of members of the House of People, that is the Lok Sabha. So here the question is asked for the correct statement. Since statement 2 is only correct, the correct answer is option B, 2 only. Consider the following statements, and these statements are about e-cigarettes. The question is asked for the correct statements. So, if you look at the first statement, It states that e-cigarettes are battery-powered devices which are used to smoke. So this is correct. But the statement further states that it does not contain nicotine. This is wrong. E-cigarettes are made up of a flavored solution which contains a varying concentration of nicotine. Since this part of statement 1 is wrong, it makes the whole statement wrong. Here, the question asks for the correct statement, and if you see the options given here, two options containing statement 1 can easily be eliminated, which are options A and B. Now, the second statement is a bit confusing, as you may not be sure whether e-cigarettes contain all these compounds like acetaldehyde, formaldehyde and acetone. Also, whether they are carcinogens or not, that is the cancer-causing elements or not. Because we may not always remember every detail about a particular topic. But if you see the options that are given here, the option C and D, statement 2 is mentioned and only one option contains statement 3. So try to find out if the statement 3 is correct or not, since statement 2 becomes automatically correct here. The use of nicotine as an ingredient in any food item is prohibited under the Food Safety and Standards Prohibition and Restrictions on Sales Regulation 2011 of the Food Safety and Standards Act of 2006. So here the third statement is correct. So finally we can arrive at the option D, which is 2 and 3 only, since both the statements are correct. Now also remember that it was found that e-cigarettes contain potential carcinogens like acetaldehyde, formaldehyde and acetone, that is mentioned in the second statement. With reference to the Generalized System of Preferences program of USA, consider the following statements and the question is asked for the correct statements. Here the first statement is, it was first instituted in the year 1976 and is the largest and oldest US trade preference program. This GSP program actually came into force, or it was first instituted in the year 1976. So this statement is correct. Here they have told in the second statement that in 2018, India was the second largest beneficiary under the program, according to the Office of United States Trade Representative. Here the second statement is incorrect, as India was the largest beneficiary under the program, according to this Office of United States Trade Representative, not the second largest beneficiary. So here the question is asked for correct statements. The correct answer is option A, 1 only. Which of the following are used to calculate the fiscal deficit? They have given tax revenues, borrowings, capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. And we have to choose the correct answer from the options given below. The fiscal deficit is the total expenditure minus the total receipts except the debt capital receipts. So here the debt capital receipt consists of borrowings and other liabilities. So these borrowings and other liabilities are not taken into account while calculating the fiscal deficit. And if you see here, the total expenditure refers to both the capital and the revenue expenditure. So if you eliminate the item B, which is the borrowings, the correct answer is option D, 1, 3 and 4 only. With this, we come to the end of this session. Do like, comment and share the video and do subscribe to Shankar IAS Academy YouTube channel for latest videos and updates. Stay focused and motivated, friends. Thank you.